Hi friends, good afternoon. Today I am going to discuss one important topic, which is the certified photocopy, the given exam on the date 17/6/18. Whoever don't know how the certified copy will come and how the evaluator will check the our papers, what basis they will check, any roll registration number is there or any roll number is there, anything you can see here. This is just plain who the evaluator will check before going them. The institute will remove whatever the content here, just based on the barcode only. They will check paper and there is their reference numbers. We can't understand that. So you can see here whatever student used to fill here, that is not there. They will remove that and they will queue on the barcode. Then the paper will go to evaluator and they will check and they will return the paper. So just I will discuss, this is the indirect certified photocopy. Just I will discuss some silly mistakes. If you return also in small mistakes, how you will lose the mark. This is a 57 near to exemption. How it is marks gone reduced? What is the problem here? Just I will discuss some important points. Just see carefully this one. Let us start. Question number one, you can see here I kept a question paper, certified copy, and laptop here, suggested answer is there, but you can't see. Let us start. First question will start. Okay, you can see the question one, what is GST section 1, part GST section A. This is June 2018 indirect taxation question paper. All questions are compulsory in part A. Choose the correct option from the amongst the four alternative given. So this is the here answer, part A, section 1. See, if you write a question number properly, question 1, see here, you can see here, question 1 A, one second, can zoom it. Okay. Question 1 A, in that first, in that option, if you write this, or you can see here, you can see here, question 1 A, first answer is D, second B, third A, fourth B, fifth C. So 1, 2, 3, you no need to write question and answer, you just write the points properly, you will get answer, they will allow for this. So no need to worry, don't waste your time writing each and everything, because suggested answer also you can't see here. Suggested answer, they given the same way answer. See, first one D, second one B, third one A, fourth one B, and fifth one C. The same way if you write here, they will answer, they will check and they will give you answer. So don't waste time to writing the objectives, questions and answer, please, because it will waste of time. So just check how they are given marks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. First question, first A, first that one, 5 points are right. So they are given 5 points. Match the following. You just write for their understanding. Match the following. Okay, column A, column B, first D, second A, 3 B, 4 E, 5 C. They given correct marks, they given the right marks, and they given the marks. See, 5, 5 here. So this is correct, the whatever they checked. Just I'm telling how can you write. So true and false. Question C, you can see here, question paper also I will show you. Question number okay, it is C, that is true and false. You just write true and false. First question, second question, third, fourth, fifth, you just write true or false. Don't sit and write every sentence and don't make it right, wrong. Please, it will be waste of time. See, they are checked. Okay, question one is true, true. This is false. Okay, this is wrong answer. This is true. This is correct answer. This is wrong answer. So, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 correct. They are given three marks. Fourth, this is fill in the blanks. In that, 1, 2, 2 correct and all are false, wrong. So they given 2 marks. So totally they given marks here. So let us start. So in first question, I'm telling you, if objective type of question, don't sit and write each and every sentence. Just write question number and write the proper answer. And that question number also you are writing, proper answer number also you are writing properly. They will give marks. So don't waste your time to writing each and everything. So let us start with the part two. Part two, they asked, answer any four question. That is, what do you mean by GST Council? What is the guiding principles or its function? And second one, state the advantage of GST. See, where if you go there and see the suggested answer, whatever in the suggested answer, if they find that points, they will mark it and they will give the marks. Okay, what they are given, GST Council is, they didn't give here, just dispute regarding taxes. GST Council is the sole all acts forced to counsel any dispute regarding taxes, any changes in the tax rates or any amendments related to GST will handle the council. So for that they given 2 marks. Whatever if you didn't see anything in the suggested answer, they won't give marks. So totally for here they give marks, nothing they given, because 2 marks is there. And for this is advantage of GST, here they given 2 marks. So 2 and 2 totally they given 4 marks. You can see here, you can see here, okay, 2 and 2, 4 marks they are given. And whenever you are writing, write the question number, new question in the next page. If even single line also, go for the next page. Don't write in the same page. They won't, no need to worry about that. Okay. What if they are giving certified copy also, they will write here certified copy. And whenever you are turning the page, please write in the corner PTO. This is gone. Actually, you have to write PTO. PTO means please turn over. Okay, so they will turn on, obviously they will see, but you just careful about yourself. Now in question number part 2, question number 2a b, they given one question, that is, see, stepwise markings are there. A performance classical dance exempt, half marks. Performing television, actually it is exempt, it is not exempt but written as a exempt, so it is gone marks, they removed marks. Services as brand ambassador, taxable, half marks. See, it is a step marking. If you given this correct, if it is not, this is wrong and this is right, they will reduce all the marks. It is not, this one is correct, half marks. This is not correct, 0 marks. This is correct, half marks. This is again not correct, 0 marks. So this is correct, half marks. Like this total, obviously it will come wrong because a lot of points are wrong. So totally they given 1.5 marks, whatever the steps are correct. Okay, so this is actually they did correct valuation. Second one, directly, see, you can see here, didn't go directly the next question. You can choose any question first. This is a question number 5. This is a A option. So what they asked, question number 5, see, whatever you are feeling the question is, you can go for first, no need to go serial wise. So question number 5, list the category of person who are not liable for registration under GST. State the list for category of person who are required to compulsory registration under GST law. See here, you can see they given 1 and 2 marks here, because totally that question will come for totally 7 marks. Question 5th A will come totally 7 marks, and in here got totally 7 marks. If you write extra also, they won't care about that. If the proper points are there, only they will give the marks. Zero rated supply, nil rated supply, whose turnover below 20 lakhs, who's doing only the intrastate transaction. So these points are correct, they are given. They feel these points are wrong, so they make it wrong. But whatever the 2 marks you given points, they given 2 marks here. You can see here, agricultural product, okay, here this is also they given 1 marks. Required compulsory registration under GST, who has to compulsory registration. So for them, if you wrote the correct points, they given 1, 2, 3, 4 marks. So totally here 4 and 3, 7 marks. So it's got out 7 marks. So no need to worry, if you write extra answer, it is wrong also. Whatever the correct marks, they will give. Question number 5A. 7 marks out 7 marks they given. So next you can see question number 5th Question number fifth, whatever they felt, these points are correct, they given 2 marks. Totally it's came 2, 2 and 1, 5 marks. Okay, next question, question number 6. I will tell you some important points here. Question number 6, you just write down new questions in new page. Don't write down in the same page, because they will give the additional papers. Okay, you can see here question number 4 A. Actually, see question number 4, this is a question, and this is actually, this is answer is totally correct, but they reduced to 2 marks. That is actually for 7 marks. Question number 4A, it is actually for 7 marks. I don't know why they reduced. As per whatever the suggested answer, we have to calculate, because this totally marks, whatever the suggested answer, as per suggested answer, 2360,000 is correct answer, even 14%. Just the problem is here, CGST and SGST not segregated, directly taken 18%. We should not take directly 18%. We have to segregate 14 lakh into 9%. You have to show CGST and SGST. Due to that, they removed 2 marks. It is very bad, because 1 mark is okay, but they removed 2 marks. Everything is correct, only you not segregated CGST and SGST, they removed 2 marks. So while solving the paper, be careful what they are asking. Is it they are expecting CGST, HGST separately, or in same point? This is, I will tell you, question 4A, this page, and I will tell you what is here, the B question, at the last point. This is a last page, question B, because lot of doubts are there, so it's took in last. Even that also they given marks, and they properly calculated, and they given in the front page. If you write proper question, main question, sub questions, they will properly check and they will give you marks. See, last page 4th B and middle 4th A. So you can see here, once again, this is 4th question, 5 and 3, they given proper answer. And one more point I will tell you, in this paper extra questions are written. Okay, question number 7, this is a extra question, because they asked only 4 questions, but this is attempted 5th question. So question number 7, this is a 5th one, means 4th already done, but 5th question. So they given marks, but they didn't add, they said evaluator written, ignore being extra answer. So whatever you wrote starting question only get included. Please don't write extra. If extra written also, they won't give any marks. If you written also, whatever starting question you are attended, that only it will get calculated. Okay, this one is extra, and one more question is also extra. Okay, this is also extra, so that one also they given marks, but ignore being extra answer. So extra answer, due to that they didn't given marks. This is the point. If you wrote extra questions also, they won't cut the marks, but whatever you written first only, that will only include, not whatever you written in the letter. And one more big mistake I will tell you. Okay, please no one do these mistakes, because due to that exemption lost. This is customs question number 10. They ask ascertain the accessible value. This question is very easy, return everything, but the problem is should not add cost of transportation, loading and unloading 3500. Due to this, whole question got wrong and got 3 marks. Instead of 9 marks, it's got 3 marks, where is total is 57. If you got 6 marks, it will come 63 marks. What is the punishment of this? The punishment of this small mistake, 6 months you have to sit again, read the same and write the exam, and you don't know the question paper will come easy or tough. So please, when you are solving, be careful. Cost of transporting, loading and unloading, this is a question number 10A of customs. Cost of transportation, loading and unloading, you should not right? Due to that FOB value, okay, this is wrong. Insurance fine, if you have fried 20% on FOB, 2000 fine. Value in they given two value 64. So due to that 1, 2, 3 marks they given. This is wrong due to that. Total came wrong. If you are convert also, obviously it wrong means totally whatever you applied, there is nothing wrong. Instead of this, whole calculation got wrong. Getting 9 marks, it is reduced in 3. It is a 57 total marks. If you got 6 marks, it will go 63. So due to one silly mistake, exemption gone. And punishment of this 6 month, you have to read the same question, same book, and you have to give the answer. So be careful about while doing your silly mistakes. This is just the telling of this question, answer sheet certified copy. Question number 1, objectives, you can write only the numbers properly. And the second point, if you are writing extra answers also, whatever you are wrote starting, that one only it will include it. So try to avoid writing extra because it is a waste of time. And third one is, don't do silly mistake like CGS, TSGST. If you wrote the separate, you would have get 2 marks. And customs, do it one small simple mistake, it is gone. Instead of 9 marks, got 3 marks. So total marks is 57. If you got that 6 marks and 2 marks, 7 marks, it would have go 65. But now it is again, you have to sit and write the exam. This is the punishment. So whenever you are writing exams, make the mind cool and write the exams. So it will be beneficial. This is it. If you like the video or you have any queries or any kind of problem or any solution you need, just please write down your comment on comment box. Please subscribe the channel, that is a CME Leaf channel, for more update. Click on bell icon so you will get to know my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.